This week I've been spending a little bit of time just sort of organizing things around here, just because the path was getting a little bit narrow between the door and my workbench. And I came across this box that a buddy gave me some time ago. He said there's an old monitor in there that doesn't work properly that he's tried to fix and wasn't succeeding at. So he said I could have it if I wanted to fix it or tear it apart or whatever. It was mine. Okay. So I'll have to put it back together to figure out what's wrong with it. Ah, he started replacing capacitors. Okay. Wonder why he thought that was the thing to do. But before we get started on that, the usual start to the evening. This is Juice of the Oats Oatmeal Stout from Oxus Brewing in Winnipeg. Had this one many times before. It is quite a nice little beer. Now then, let's see what he's done to this thing so far. Looks like he's replaced three capacitors. And that one, did he replace that or not? That is a Capex Calm brand. And so are the other ones that haven't been molested yet. So I think that's an original one that he was trying to get off and just didn't. I think before I try anything, I'll clean these three up and trim them, just reflow them, and go reflow that one just to make sure that's making good contact. Then I'll throw it back in and see where we're at and what's not working about this thing, because I don't have any other information than that. It looks, though, like he had come to the conclusion somehow that it needed a recapping. So he went to DigiKey and spent the money on a bunch of decent components. Should I just replace that one since he's halfway through there? Yeah, maybe. There, that is out. Let's see if it even needed to be replaced. 47.11 ESR 0.82. That is a 47 microfarad. Okay. Ah, regardless, it's out now. Might as well just do it. So that was a bit of a pain in the ass to get the solder out of that through hole. So part of the reason why this was so hard to get the components off and clean the board or clean the holes out is that the negative side of this thing is on a ground plane, which sucks an awful lot of heat away from the joint. So I had to bump up the temperature of my iron a little bit. Not super pretty, but I think it's electrically okay. I'm going to just toss this back into the monitor and see where we're at. I said, I don't think that fixed it, but I want to see what the problem looks like. This is nothing worse than trying to fix something without knowing what exactly you're fixing. There's the control buttons up there for the front panel controls. There's a speaker. There's another one over here. They go down to connectors in there. Okay, so the power supply board is still in here. That's the power supply board there. If the problem is caps, I would have expected it to be in the power supply, not on the main board where he was looking. But I guess we'll try that later. And we'll just plug these connectors in where they obviously go. And I don't know. I suppose it would be intelligent of me to ask him what was wrong with it, but where's the fun in that? Oh, hey, we got backlight and static.
Can you see that? You can't see that.
Something's happening. At this point, I shut off the camera accidentally and continued testing and troubleshooting a little bit and discovered that it wasn't really showing much of a picture when I connected it to my computer. There was something on the screen, but it was basically digital noise. We now return you to a video that I remembered to record. I don't think that looks like power supply to me. That looks like digital board processing kind of stuff. And I think that's also beyond just what a simple recapping will do. I mean, it might be some kind of a stabilizing capacitor on the digital board, but I don't buy it. It's more likely to be something's just damaged in the signal processing that's, you know, beyond repair, other than replacing the whole digital board. I suppose I could look up what that would cost.
So I found a few hits on the part number of that board. Unfortunately, yeah. So I don't even know what currency that is or what country that is. I don't know what currency that is or what country it's from. No, not going to order from those guys. I don't care where it comes from. That's more reasonable. Except for it's out of stock. Of course. Yeah, so that's a bit of a bust. Well, I guess my options are to strip this thing down for parts and see if I can find anything worth salvaging in it, I suppose.
I did kind of put this thing back together just to put it aside for a while I was looking for the parts, but then I decided after I looked at that it's not going back together again. It is a salvage mission now. So there are four screws on the sides like that. Initially, I thought it was clips, but nope. And there was two screws down there holding the bezel to the rest of the system. But I've got them out now, so that just pops right off. And then I can get at the other, these four screws on the sides, and that'll take it back to where we had it before. And being a bit less careful now that this is a salvage mission rather than a repair journey. I should change what it says in the sign, but I'm not going to. I'm going to just toss this around here. So unplug that little cable. Unplug the backlight cables. One of them's got a latch on it. Three of them don't. I don't know if they broke off or what. But anyway, whatever. And then this whole guy sort of lifts up. And that's kind of where we get back to where I came into this little journey. I'll strip that out later. You've already seen that taken apart. I'm more interested in taking this apart and seeing what is in here that is salvageable. Oh, a circuit board up there that does things. So what do we have here? We have an inductor, which means there's a buck or a boost circuit happening in there, probably. Oh, what's that little three-pin dude? A 1117, a 25-volt regulator. Okay. That definitely confirms our suspicion that that is a power supply. Not that there was much doubt with that there. Other than that, this board takes this, and it has a bunch of little flat flexes that go up and over the edge and to the monitor itself. This thing is so big, I gotta keep reorienting it on here and keep throwing it around. That just comes out like that. How do we go the next distance? Maybe that? Okay, I think that's right. There, that's that next piece off. So now we're just down to this little board and the glass. Oh, hello. There is the actual LCD panel. And see the sort of pixel grid there? Well, that is the part that basically gets turned on or off to block or transmit the light through from the backlight. And I guess there will be R, G, and B pixels that will just block or transmit red, green, or blue light as they get turned on and off. by the magic on this little board. And, oh, there is some smarts on that board. Okay. It'll be demultiplexing the signal from that connector to send it out to all of these little ribbons that go onto here. Oh, and then along the side, there's these little ribbons, including one that I tore off there, that will, I guess, be the horizontal. Looks like there might be some circuitry etched into the glass there. It comes around and connects to those, and then they connect on. I don't know. Again, most of my experience in video stuff was back in CRT days. Oh, looks like there's a little screen protector on there. I guess that makes a certain amount of sense. Can I get under that with my knife? It's a fairly stiff one, too. There, so is that a screen protector? Is that a polarizer, maybe? Yeah. You see the difference there? So that is a polarizing layer. Now we get to the backlight and its diffuser. I'll figure out how to take it out of here. So I think I need to pull these. My spudger again. I think I need to pull this little plastic bezel off its clips here. Colt cathode fluorescent lamp in LCD panel. If I can figure out what the voltage of the power supply is, or if I can get the high voltage to run independent of the control board, maybe I'll be able to use this cold cathode light as a light source. I remember another dude on YouTube played with those to create illumination. Who was it? DIY Perks, I think his name is. Yeah. If I can find it, I'll put a link up in the corner of the screen. Okay, well, I guess I can just do that then. Okay, that's got that out of the way. And there we have a diffusion sheet. Put that someplace where it won't get destroyed. Now then, in here, we have some wires molded. Oh, okay, that's just strain relief for these wires here going to the backlight. Fair enough. Get rid of that. Now then, we just have... Oh! Not just the backlight. It's another diffuser. Okay. It's a different type of diffuser than that one. One of them's a little bit more reflective than the other one. Okay. Well, those are keepers. Now, what have we got? Yet another layer of diffusion. And again, it's different than these other two. It's similar to the front one, but oh well, that really kills the reflection of the lights up there, doesn't it? Unless you get it super close. Okay. Okay, there's one more layer of that's sort of diffusion. It's a thick piece of plastic. Let me get the edge on. There you go. You can't see that, but that's like 5 millimeters thick. And it's got this pattern on the back of it. It's screen printed on with kind of a translucent white or something. Yeah, that dot pattern there. There's my finger behind it for scale. Set that aside. Okay, so here is that the actual light source? No. That's just an opaque piece of highly reflective white plastic. Okay. So the lights themselves then are in the edges here. There's two tubes running along that edge and two tubes running along the bottom here. I guess it's really one tube that runs down hits whatever is at the end there and doubles back. Can I get those out without breaking them? Oh, wait, that whole assembly and sell them with little screws. Okay, that's easy. So there is one of our cold cathode lights. Oh, those aren't glass tubes. They're some kind of, they feel a little bit more plasticky and they're a bit more flexible. Hmm. And I have to research how much power these things take. So there's four wires going in there. These four wires here. Hmm. I wonder if we can light them up without the rest of the system. I'm just going to pull this other one out and then grab the power supply again. I give this maybe a 20%, maybe even less chance of success. But you never know. Odds are pretty good that I'm going to have to send some kind of a signal back along this cable to there to get those to light, but I don't know what that signal is going to be. There's an O/F and a dim, and then we got two 12 volts, two grounds, and two 5 volts, and another ground over there. So I'm not entirely sure which one of those, if any, well, maybe the dim will tell the backlights what to do. I am completely guessing, but let's see what happens. Right now, this is just sitting here with nothing connected to it other than those and the power. So I plug in the power, keeping a respectful distance. Okay, nothing happens over there. Right. Unplug. Let's connect that O/F to a ground, which is black's a ground. Ground is probably safer than putting a high voltage on it. I don't know. Trying things. Plug that in and see what happens. Nothing. Okay. Unplug. Let's connect the O/F to a 5 volt. Okay. Let's see what that does. I'm leaning back each time. Hey, we have lights. They're very bright. They're kind of a cool white, I would say. Hmm. Those probably aren't bright enough to light up my workbench, but they're fairly bright. And what happens if I put them behind some of this diffusion here? Okay. So here we have that whole stack up. We've got the cold cathode lights edge lighting that 5 millimeter thick chunk. And then we've got that reflective white sheet at the back, and then three layers of the different diffraction stuff on the front. Some colors to put in here. Well, everything's kind of backlit right now, so it's hard to see, but you know, that may just be useful to assist with my lighting. I may not replace my lighting above there, but I may augment it somehow. So I could probably put that back into its bezels, actually, and I should, but I'll do that off camera. You saw me take it apart, so putting it back together won't be any different. Even though I couldn't fix the thing, I think that might just be a win. And I think it also further proves that the power supply is not the problem. Just calm that white down a little bit. That's getting pretty bright over there and hard on the eyes. So, well, didn't fix it, but I learned something. And I got some cool salvage out of the deal, so that's pretty neat. Thanks for coming along for the ride. I'm always impressed that there's anybody watching these videos at this point at the end, but there always is. So that's pretty cool. I do appreciate you guys watching and commenting and asking questions and all the rest of that. Thanks for coming along tonight. Comments and questions down below. As usual, I'll talk to you later.